Hey guys! In this video, I will show you the easiest way to set up an external GPU on a 2013 Retina MacBook Pro equipped with a GT750M dedicated GPU. With this setup, you will be able to accelerate the internal screen or to use an external display. The laptop can still be used standalone. In this case, we connected it to a video projector. Don't pay attention to the green strips, they are related to the camera and not visible in real life. Here are the performance levels I experienced with a GeForce GTX 1060. This is a summary of the overall system with the three GPU represented. About the hardware, I'm using an Akitio Thunder2 PCI Express enclosure with the EVGA GTX 1060 SC 6GB model. I've removed the power jack and soldered another connector on the free PCB footprint. We'll start from there with a unique partition. First, use the Bootcamp assistant to create a bootable USB disk with the proper MacBook drivers. You can set up your thumb drive with another program, like Rufus. Just make sure that it has an EFI boot method. On this model of MacBook Pro, the default installation method is UEFI. You can check that using GPT Fdisk. This part is optional on this model. If you see the words protective MBR, you're good to go. Otherwise, you can convert it using GPT Fdisk. You will find the link of a tutorial in the description. Your Mac will then reboot and start installing Windows. Once the installation is complete, you can verify your BIOS mode by typing msinfo32.exe in the start menu. If you check the device manager, you'll see that only the DGPU is detected at this point. The next step consists on installing Refind from your Mac partition. Just open the installation file. Everything will be automatic. Then, you need to mount the EFI partition and edit the Refine configuration file. Type the two following commands and look for the refine.conf on the EFI partition. Just delete the comment symbol at the beginning of the line, spoof OS version. Reboot without pressing any key and select Windows on the Refine screen. Go back in the device manager. Your computer now sees two graphic cards, your iGPU and DGPU. I'm not sure if the next step is necessary, but you can install display driver and installer to delete your DGPU driver. Look also for the Windows version of GPU switch and move it to your desktop. You will need Visual C++ Registry Bootable from Microsoft to open it. I did install each of its versions, just to be sure. Open the file integrated.bat with administrator rights. Check that it worked and delete your display driver using DDU. Choose to turn off the computer at the end of the process. Now comes the tricky part. Turn on your computer and plug your eGPU when you see the Refine screen. As the eGPU has been set as primary, Windows should boot each time without any problem. Open your device manager. You will see three graphic cards. If you open DXDiag, you can check that the Iris Pro graphics is the one in use. Download and install NVIDIA GeForce Experience and the latest NVIDIA driver. The device manager will be updated with your GPU models. In my case, GTX 1060 and GT750M. Relaunch GPU switch, just to be sure, then reboot. When rebooting, you don't need to unplug the eGPU. Now, the device manager shows an error code 12 on the eGPU that has not enough resources to work properly. Just right-click on the GT750M and choose to disable it. Relaunch GPU switch and reboot. Now your eGPU works properly. Open the NVIDIA control panel, go to Physics and set it to Automatic. This allows your eGPU to accelerate your computer in order to use its internal display. That's it, you can now play your games with desktop class performance. Every time you want to use your eGPU, you will have to use GPU switch and disable the DGPU. At the end of your gaming session, just remember to reactivate your DGPU. Otherwise, you risk a black screen at startup. For the supply, I've modified an Xbox 360 power brick. At first, I was using an Xbox 360S adapter, but the wires were too thin, causing a voltage drop. Any game crashed, and the GPU fan was running at max speed. When playing a game, the current can easily reach 8 to 10 amps. I hope that this video will help you. If you liked it, you can give it a thumbs up or share it. Thanks for watching!